Hello everybody, I'm Rafa and welcome back to JRE in a Nutshell. This week we have a special, kind of different episode. I didn't really see the point on doing timestamps. I will explain on each of the opinions or analyses or whatever you want to call them. And I'm just going to do a short analyze on each of them. We have three completely different topics this week. We have first David Goggins, who is a motivational kind of a podcast or episode. We have the Save the Parks, what I call the Fuck Watts episode. And this is, of course, just fucking around. And we have Leah Thompson. I hope it's Leah. And this is general knowledge. And cool. So let's get right to it, guys. So let's start with David Goggins. This episode, I didn't see the point on timestamping it because they speak 99% about his life. The other 1% is just Joe telling some life stories that we heard already a couple times. So that part is not really that important. But if I would have chosen one episode to timestamp this week, it would have been this one because it's crazy good, super motivational. This motherfucker is a walking definition of resilience. It's crazy how strong and tough and just mind focused and goal oriented this guy is. Very, very impressive. And of course, super infectious, this motivation that when the episode finishes, you just want to put your running shoes on and go hustle and go do some hard shit. This super crazy. The timestamps are not necessary in my opinion because, like I say, they speak mostly about him, his family, his goals, his body issues, is like all of this stuff, and they jump just back and forth between family. They jump straight here, then they jump here, then they go back to family, then they go back here, and it's just all about him. And I would recommend that you watch everything. If not, check the highlights out. I haven't seen them, but I'm sure that they are boosted with motivational speeches because the whole episode is like that. So definitely around 3.5, maybe 4 knots even. But like I say, the timestamps are not really necessary. You can just fucking play this episode on whatever time you want, start on whatever time you want, and it will definitely be worth your time. And now for the Fuckwats episode. I call it the Fuckwats episode to all of these episodes where Joe has Ari and Mark, and in this case, this fat guy, I fucking always forget his name, or Joey, or Kurt, Tom. Tom Segura, I mean, and you know, all of this, it's just boys' night. They just fucking around and doing mushrooms and smoking weed and drinking. And, you know, it's just pockets of cool information or interesting information in the middle. But 90% of the episode is just the boys fucking around, which is cool, but it's not really what I enjoy. I normally skip those episodes. This one I watch specifically for the sake of this channel, but so I would have something of base to talk about. But it's almost 5 hours of the boys just, you know, fucking around. And like I said, if I want to watch something that I to laugh, then I watch stand-up. I love stand-up. Ari talks about his stand-up, his new special. He posted it on YouTube for free, so I definitely recommend it. Check it out. When they spoke about it, I stopped the interview to watch the stand-up special, and it's 1.5 hours, completely hilarious. Definitely recommend it. And Mark, I found out that he also published his also as well on YouTube. So the link is also in the comments. And that I would watch stand-up if I want to laugh. I don't watch this. It doesn't really, it's funny sometimes for me, but not really. If it's something that you would enjoy, then it's 5 hours of fucking fantasy for you, paradise. But for me, I would give it, for example, maybe a couple knots, not more than that. So yeah, that's really it for me. There's nothing more to say about it. And the episode with Erica Thompson. Erica Thompson is a beekeeper. So she normally, actually, I wouldn't watch this episode. I watched it for the sake of this channel, and it turned out to be really interesting. It's very visual. So if you decide to watch it like properly, don't only listen to it like I do sometimes in the car or at the gym or something. With this one, there's a, they show a lot of YouTube videos and a lot of images, so it's definitely worth to actually watch the interview. It's interesting. If you like beekeeping or you're into it, 100% check it out. If you don't care about it, like me, at least watch the highlights. For me, Joe said, for example, that the most interesting fact that he learned from this interview was the fact that the bees didn't emigrate, or they are not native from North America. They were brought from South America. For me, the most interesting thing I found about this interview was the fact that keeping bees is not really a hard job. For some reason, I always thought it was a lot of work, but it turns out it isn't. Like during the summer, during the season, you check them once a week, and at the end of the day, you collect the honey. And it's like, wow, it makes me even think about doing some research and maybe why not, let's keep one hive, let's keep some bees if it's not a lot of work, you know? We will see, of course. But I think it's a pretty cool hobby, and if it's not a lot of work, why not? So if you're interested about it, check it out. If not, you know, not 3.5 knots, not more than that, because I found it interesting. But otherwise, it could easily be a lot less if you don't really care about it. And that is a wrap for another JRE in a nutshell. Thank you very much for listening. I hope you like it. I hope you find it that I'm slowly getting better at this. I feel like it. And thank you, Nati, Alejandro, Stefan, for the positive and negative reviews. I hope you can see some improvement. As usual, please like, follow, comment, all that stuff, subscribe, and tell your friends. If you like it, tell your friends. If you don't like it, don't tell your friends. Tell me in the comments, and then I will make it better, and then you can tell your friends. So thanks again, and I'll see you next week. Cheers.